In the multiple card setup, you have a card for specific things. So students, you'll want to get out your stack of cards. We're going to number your first card. One. On this card, you want your attention grabber. You will eventually learn that there are four parts to a functional introduction. But right now, we're just working on attention grabbers and thesis statements. On your second card, we're going to label that number two so that if they get out of order, you can get the order in more quickly. We're going to label that thesis statement. From there, in the multiple card method, you have options. Remember, option one is that each piece of information gets its own card. Option two is that you put the entire body of your speech on one card so that you're only using three cards, maybe a fourth for your conclusion. Okay? There are advantages to both ways. I like putting the entire body on one card because then I'm not at risk of losing my spot as quickly, and I'm not over-relying on my cards, especially for a short speech like an impromptu speech. So using option two, outline the main points on the card. We're going to use the same method we did previously. Some students like the tangibility of holding those cards and flipping through them because it reminds them, I'm at this point in my speech, I can move on. I'm at this point in my speech, I say my bit and I move on. I'm at the body in my speech. When I finish my body, I conclude and I'm finished. Okay, that's why people like the multiple card method. The risk you have is that if you drop your cards or get your cards out of order, you could get lost. It's also a reason we do not encourage students to memorize speeches, because if you do not memorize perfectly, or if you're not good at memorization and you get lost in your memorization, you can sometimes get stuck in a speech. Same reason. Okay. The process of thinking through your topic is the same. We are not working with research notes on these cards yet. That's going to happen later this week. So let's talk through one of our topics from our Apples to Apples card. This card is the Milky Way. It says the galaxy that includes the sun, its solar system, and a chewy layer of caramel. Unless you're from the Midwest, and it's a chewy layer of caramel. Whichever way you want to say it. So, students, what are some topics we could talk about related to this card?
Candy.
You can talk about candy. Student did that last year. She got this card and ended up talking about Milky Way bars, she talked about Mars bars, she talked about Snickers as well. So that was a cute speech. It was a good way to address this topic. What else could you talk about?
The history.
You could talk about the history of it, but that would include research, and you have limited time.
Space.
You could talk about space in general. That would work. What else?
Aliens.
The possibility of aliens. That might require some research. You have limited time. You could talk about constellations in the Milky Way. You could talk about when it's easier to see the stars in the Milky Way.
Can you talk about aliens?
She just mentioned the aliens.
We could talk about like comets and stuff.
Comets?
Like Halley's Comet.
Halley's Comet, like we talked about in English class the other day. Good.
Black holes.
Black holes, space-related topics. Space-related topics means you could also talk about what?
Space exploration
and astronauts. That would work.
Multi-universes.
The idea of multi-universes and potential space travel. Okay.
Or alternate
universes. A lot of those topics would require research, and you don't have time for that necessarily. Okay. Good. take your topic, whatever it is, and think of your attention grabber, just like you did previously, and get your attention grabber on that card. Usually what we do in this card method is you write it kind of in the middle of your card, so it's really easy to see, and that makes it easier to write neatly. Hint, hint. Your thesis statement, remember this needs to be a statement, a full sentence, not a question. It should clarify your speech and where your speech is going for your audience. And then based on your thesis statement, you outline the body of your speech. So take about 5 minutes, maybe a little bit more, and determine what you might do with the topic.